ಶ್ರೀ ಗುರುಭ್ಯೋ ನಮಃ. ಗುರುರ್ಬ್ರಹ್ಮ ಗುರುರ್ವಿಷ್ಣು ಗುರುರ್ದೇವೋ ಮಹೇಶ್ವರ ಗುರುಸಾಕ್ಷಾತ್ ಪರಬ್ರಹ್ಮ ತಸ್ಮೈ ಶ್ರೀ ಗುರವೇ ನಮಃ. ಗುರು ಈಸ್ ಬ್ರಹ್ಮ, ಗುರು ಈಸ್ ವಿಷ್ಣು, ಗುರು ಈಸ್ ಮಹೇಶ್ವರ, ಗುರು ಈಸ್ ಸಾಕ್ಷಾತ್ ಪರಬ್ರಹ್ಮ. ಉಸ್ ಗುರು ಕೋ ಹಮ್ ಲೋಗ್ ವಿ ಪ್ರೋಸ್ಟ್ರೇಟ್, ವಿ ಡೂ ಪ್ರಣಾಮ್, ವಿ ಡೂ ನಮಸ್ಕಾರ್. ವಾಟ್ ಡಸ್ ಗುರು ಡೂ ಫಾರ್ ಅಸ್? ಎಸ್, ಹಿ ಗಿವ್ಸ್ ಅಸ್ ನಾಲೆಜ್.
ಅಜ್ಞಾನತಿಮಿರಾಂಧಸ್ಯ ಜ್ಞಾನಾಂಜನಶಲಾಕಯ.
ಯು ರೆಡ್ ದಟ್ ಶ್ಲೋಕ, ರೈಟ್? ನೋ. ಅಜ್ಞಾನತಿಮಿರಾಂಧಸ್ಯ, ವಿ ಆರ್ ಆಲ್ ಇಗ್ನೋರೆಂಟ್, ವಿ ಆರ್ ಇನ್ ದಿ ಡಾರ್ಕ್. ಗುರು ರಿಮೂವ್ಸ್ ಅಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ ignorance, the blindness of ignorance, and he gives us jnananjana shalakaya. He applies the jnananjana, the knowledge of anjana, to our eyes, and he bestows us knowledge. ಅಜ್ಞಾನ ತಿಮಿರಾಂಧಸ್ಯ ಜ್ಞಾನಾಂಜನ ಶಲಾಕಯ. ಸ್ಪೆಷಲಿ ದ ಲೇಡೀಸ್ ಅಪ್ಲೈ ದಿ ಅಂಜನ, ರೈಟ್? ಬಟ್ ಗುರು ಆಲ್ಸೋ ಅಪ್ಲೈಸ್ ದಿ ಅಂಜನ ಆಫ್ ಟು ರಿಮೂವಿಂಗ್ ದಿ ಡಾರ್ಕ್ನೆಸ್ ಆ್ಯಂಡ್ ಗಿವಿಂಗ್ ನಾಲೆಜ್. ಸೊ ಗುರು, ಹೀ ಟೇಕ್ಸ್ ಫ್ರಮ್ and truth to truth, and he takes us from darkness to light. Tamasoma jyotirgamaya. And then mrutyorma amrutam gamaya, he takes us from death to immortality. He makes us all immortal. We are all the children of God, right? We are all the children of God. Where is God? God is everywhere. He is within you. He is outside. He is behind. He is in the front. He is sideways. He is up. He is down. God is everywhere. So who will give us that knowledge? Guru gives us that knowledge. Guru gives us the knowledge. God is everywhere. We have just heard, but we are not experienced that God is everywhere. We are not experienced. When God removes ignorance from us and gives knowledge, then only we will understand God is everywhere. Otherwise, we just, like a parrot, we will say God is everywhere. But in fact, we will truly know God is everywhere only when Guru gives us blessings. Guru gives Ashirvad. In the school, teachers teach you the subject, your science, maths. From KG, they teach you A, B, C, D, X, Y, Z, 1+1, right? All those things, teachers do it. But who will give you the spiritual knowledge? Spiritual knowledge is given by the preceptor, Guru, who knows all about God. All about God. So we should always worship Guru. The word Gu refers to darkness, that is ignorance. And Ru means one who removes the darkness and gives us knowledge. As children, you are always worried about your studies, your exam. I think your exam is in progress, right? So you have exam, you have to write your exam. So even you children have tension, right? Tomorrow is my exam, I have to work hard, I have to study. So many things are there. But when you think God before you do anything, then your work becomes easier. What should you pray to God? Oh God, make me study very well. Don't ask God, give me good marks in the exam, make me pass in the exam. You should not ask for that. You should ask God, oh God, make me study well. Let me be healthy so that I can concentrate in my studies. That is what you should pray to God, pray to your Guru. And whatever I study, I should remember very well. And I should write my exam very well. So your effort is more important. God will bless you, Guru will bless you, but your effort should be there. You can take the horse to the pond or to the lake for drinking water. Can you make the horse to drink? The horse has to drink of its own. You will take the horse to the river bank. So, but the horse has to drink water by itself, right? So also, you have to work hard. You should pray to God before writing your exam. You should prostrate your parents at home. You should pray to God in your shrine at home. You should take the blessings of all the elders. And then when you go for exam, you should have no tension. You are tension free, no problem for you. And when you get the paper for writing the exam, close your eyes. 1 or 2 minutes, pray to God. Okay? That is how it should be your daily activities. And you are going to get Guru Diksha. What is Diksha? Diksha, that is Guru gives you a mantra. Mantra for what? Mantra for chanting God's name. You all pray to God, right? Do you all pray to God? What do you pray to God? What do you pray to God? You go to the temple. You close your eyes, join your hands. Huh? Wealthy and healthy life for yourself. You should pray for not for yourself, you should pray for others. If somebody is sick, you should pray. Your friend or your parents at home, somebody is sick. You should pray, oh God, make my friend healthy. Let him get over his sickness. Right? See, you should pray for the good of others. Okay? When you pray for others, pray for the good of others, you will be more happy. Right? You pray for yourself, you will become selfish. So, mantra is given to Guru, gives you the mantra. Mantra is all powerful. When you get mantra from the Guru, it is very powerful. The name, for chanting the name, Guru gives you the mantra with full of energy. And you should chant the mantra sincerely. We get knowledge only by our Shraddha, sincerity. If there is no Shraddha, then you don't get anything. Shraddha is very important. You have heard the Avang, Bhava Cha Bhuka, right? God is Keval Bhava Cha Bhuka Ayato. God is only hunger of your Bhava, or the emotional attachment towards Him. Your attachment to God, attachment to Guru is more important. Otherwise, just chanting Om Namah Shivaya, Om Namah Shivaya without any bhav, without any attachment towards the deity or the name which you are chanting. So, with full devotion, with sincerity, you should chant God's name. Just now you all said we do all prayer at home. Prayer is different and chanting japa or mantra is different. Prayer is meant for the good of yourself and also for the good of others. Whereas mantra is only for your own good, for thinking about God and making God our own. You should make God your own. So when you keep chanting God's name always, God will become yours. God is always with you. Though He is always with you, you should experience, when you start chanting God's name, you will experience that God is with you. He is protecting you. He is helping you in all the ways. So you start experiencing that God is listening to my prayer. Right? You have seen on the TV serials and all. They pray to God and God listens to them. And their prayer is answered. So many such serials are there, right? So, you have to become, to chant God's name, you have to become virtuous. You should not fight amongst yourself. You should not say anything bad about others. You should always think good. You should be good. And you should do good. You should see, you should hear, you should speak. Everything should be good. You should not find fault with anybody. You should not go home and tell the parents, my teacher has scolded at me, my teacher has bet me. If you don't do well in the exam, you will do all that. My teacher has not taught me properly. So you blame your teachers also, right? So you should not blame your teachers also, who is teaching you, who is taking all the efforts to teach you. You don't do well sometimes because you don't pay attention in your studies. You will be playing mischief with your student who is sitting beside you. So all those things you should not do. Work while you work, play while you play. Similarly, when you want to chant God's name, think of nothing else other than chanting the name. Say the prayer, chant the name of the Lord. The mirror of the heart baby wiper clean. Tasting His sweetness at every step, bathing in His name that bath weary souls. Various are Thy names, O Lord, in every name Thy power resides. Said, no times are needful for chanting of Thy name. So, no times is set for chanting God's name. All the time is meant for chanting God's name. No times are set. Nothing is required. So you should chant God's name. Many times we just idle away our time, just unnecessarily talking or telling something about others, gossip. Gossip we do, na? That we do. So that idle time you should make use for chanting God's name. Many of you are coming by bus. When you are standing for bus, instead of just standing and again looking when the bus is coming, you should chant God's name. You should use all that idle time for chanting God's name. Don't think you should not chant God's name when you are in your toilet. Anytime you can chant God's name, anytime, wherever you are. Before, as soon as you get up in the morning, you pray to God, oh God, whatever I am going to do today is done by you. You are the one who is doing. I offer it as a worship to you. Whatever I do whole day, I will offer it as a worship to you. If I am fighting with others also, that also, you should be bold enough to offer it to God. Any good thing you do, you offer it to God. Any bad thing you do, be bold enough to offer it to God and say that I will not repeat such things again and again. And in the night, when you go to bed, pray to God, oh God, whatever I have done throughout the day, that I am offering at your lotus feet. Right? Kayena vacha manasendriyairva buddhyatmanavah prakute svabhavat karomi yadyat sakalam parasmai narayanayeti samarpayami. So understand, you offer everything to God. Everything to God. Be good, do good. Okay? Sairam.